The Justice Department's special counsel investigating Donald Trump is shifting its focus to one of his top advisors. This week, prosecutors sat down with Boris Epstein for two back-to-back interviews, largely focused on Trump's efforts to overturn the 2020 election. Let's bring in Harry Litman, former U.S. attorney, former deputy assistant attorney general during the election, and host of the Talking Feds podcast. Great to see you.
Thanks, Richard. You too.
Hey, Harry, let's start. Before we get to the DOJ investigation, which I was just talking about, I want to get your reaction to the Supreme Court's abortion pill decision as of today on this Saturday. Are you surprised? And does this mean Mifepristone will survive future litigation if brought back to the high court?
I wasn't surprised, and it doesn't mean that. But the actual decision they were looking at, the standing aspect of it, the ruling that people could go forward was very weak. So I'm not surprised that they said, look, let's not do this abrupt overnight mayhem and change the whole regime. Let's settle it for now as it is and let the Fifth Circuit decide what to do. And their order says it's frozen until people make a petition for cert to come back to us. So the expectation is that nothing changes. That's the big temporary news, but mm-hmm. it could if and when it comes to the Supreme Court. And then that might be as long as a year or more from now that the final decision would be given by the court.
A year. Back to the Trump investigations.
Yep.
You know, as someone who used to work for the DOJ, how significant yep. you think here it is, Harry, that Epstein sat down for two interviews in the last 2 days, and why do you think they asked him to come back after the first day?
Yeah, so first, he is everywhere. He's maybe the main guy who actually has a significant role in both Mar-a-Lago and many January 6th investigations. They had seized his phone before. This is a soft approach rather than hailing him immediately into the grand jury. So I think the parties are kind of probing. Can he give them information, possibly even cooperate? So the next question we'll see is, does he go into the grand jury? But he's got plenty of information to impart.
And now, Harry, why do you think the prosecutors wanted to speak with Epstein? Is this him being a witness? Is this him being the doer?
Yeah. So with Trump, lawyers are kind of both, aren't they? And he certainly is. In fact, he first was officially a consultant and then changed to be a lawyer, maybe to get attorney-client information. But he is involved. But I think with this kind of consensual interview, they're first asking him, what do you know as a witness, Epstein? And then we'll see whether it gets starchy and it changes to the more antagonistic posture.
Where do you think the investigation stands?
I think it's really moving forward, especially mm-hmm. Mar-a-Lago. Indeed, after getting the testimony of the big lawyer involved, Evan Corcoran, and then other things that we know, I think it's getting pretty ripe for a final decision by Smith that would then go up to Garland to see if he'd overrule it.
I want to get to Dominion and the Fox News case. You know, Tuesday, yep. Fox News agreeing to pay $787 million to the voting system company before the trial even officially began, right? Why didn't they make that decision sooner? Why was it up to that very last moment?
Two possibilities. One, they really should have, and they won't make that mistake again. There are other cases on the horizon. Or second, Dominion at least insisted on not talking until they got that very favorable summary judgment ruling that gave them a significant tailwind. And so they were non-starter talks until a lot of people get sober on the courthouse steps.
You know, also, Harry, Dominion still has lawsuits pending against Newsmax, OAN, MyPillow CEO Mike Lindell, Overstock founder Patrick Byrne, Rudy Giuliani, Sidney Powell. A lot going on. Do you think those cases will also end in settlements as we just saw?
Well, that'll be what they want. Of course, they're not talking about deep pockets as much, but yeah. they have, especially Powell and Giuliani. Remember, Fox's whole defense was going to be, yeah, those other guys were lying, but we were just putting it on. Very strong cases against Powell and Giuliani in particular. They're now set to go to trial in mid-2024. Most cases like this settle. And that's what was, there was this missed opportunity or possibility with the trial itself with Dominion. But most cases settle. So, yes, I expect they would, but I expect Dominion will have robust settlements.